Good morning, everyone. Good morning. So, what will we do today? Good morning. What will we do today?
Grammar, reported speech.
Yes, grammar, reported speech. Right? We will wait. Yes, your poster is good, beta. Whose mic is on? Today we will discuss grammar. The grammar topic is reported speech, but this time your reported speech, it is in your interrogative formation. It is your interrogative formation. Now student, tell me, how many students go to tuition? How many of you go to tuition? At evening, have you a class? It means tuition class?
No, sir.
At evening, anyone have a, at evening, there is a tuition class? Everyone, anyone, just go to tuition class or just raise your hand in chat box. Jis logo ko tuition class hoti evening mein, just apna haath upar kare chat box. Hurry up, beta, because I want to some discuss with you. I want to discuss something.
Sir, no one.
No one. Okay. So might be today evening your class. I will take your evening today your class. Because tomorrow I will not take your class. So today evening I will take your class. Right? Might be not, I am telling you 100%. Might be I will take your English class today. So remember, we should, you should present in that time. I will send the link today. Right? It means during the noon time I will send the link. Okay? Okay, everyone? Hello?
Okay, sir.
Please, beta, answer me. Not good thing. You are not replying, it means what? That you are ignoring to your teacher. There are 9 students who are present here. Where are the others? Where are the others? Okay, tell me. 8 students. 9th is I. There are 20 to 22 students in the classroom. Only 9 students who are joined this class. 8 students, not 9 even also. 8 students who joined this class. Where are the others? No one replied. Inform your classmate. Inform to your classmate.
Okay.
What is the meaning of direct speech and indirect speech? What is the meaning of direct speech and indirect speech? Anyone have an idea the meaning of direct speech and indirect speech?
Sir, your voice is not coming properly.
Beta, I have a full network. There is a 500 to 600 kbps speed. What is the meaning of direct speech? Tell me.
The speech spoken directly.
The speech spoken directly means how? How the speech spoken directly?
When the two persons are talking directly, not indirectly.
Yes, when there are direct conversation between two persons, that is known as what? Direct speech. When two persons speak directly, that is known as what? Direct speech. Another thing that we can say is that exact words spoken by the speaker, that is known as direct speech. Exact word which is spoken by the speaker, which is known as direct speech. Got it? Got it, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Got it?
Yes, sir.
The conversation between you and me, the conversation between you and me, that is direct speech. But whenever indirect speech means the reporting, you are reporting my words to your someone else, that is known as what? Indirect speech. That is known as indirect speech. For example, if I am saying that today I will teach you grammar, right? And when you went at your home and your parents ask you that what did your teacher teach you, so what's your answer? What's your answer? So my teacher taught us English grammar, or he taught us English grammar. Got it? Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, I am giving you 5 sentences spread down in your notebook. Whether it is rough notebook, it's okay. Write down 5 sentences in your notebook. First of all, first. Write down 5 sentences in your notebook. Did you open it or not?
Sir, open.
Okay. Wait a minute. Write down. Rakesh said, comma into inverted comma, there are so many trees in the forest. Rakesh said, there are so many trees in the forest. Complete?
Yes, sir.
Complete. Second one, write down.
Yes, complete.
Second one, write down. Tabazzum said. Tabazzum. Right, write down Tabazzum spelling. T-A-B-A double S-U-M, comma into inverted comma. Their parents did not want, their parents did not want these girls leave their homes.
Next. Sir, after the did not want,
their parents did not want these girls to leave their homes. Next one. कितने हुए, तीन हुए या दो? थ्री और फोर?
सर सर टू।
हाँ
सर टू इज
टू ओनली। थर्ड वन राइट डाउन। The girl said, Kavya, mute yourself. The girl said, comma into inverted comma, my aunt will be here soon. Kavya, I am saying you mute yourself. My aunt will be here soon.
Sir, done.
Next. She said to him, comma into inverted comma, I hope Vera has been amusing you, full stop, inverted comma, over.
Sir,
how many? Four. Yes.
Please repeat the question.
Sir, I hope Vera has been amusing you. Next one. Ram said, comma into inverted comma, I am playing cricket, full stop, inverted comma, over. Now this five sentence, I am giving you 2 minutes, change into indirect speech, hurry up. Change into indirect speech. Right? I off my camera. Complete it. Did you complete it? Hurry up, beta. I want to discuss more further points.
No, sir.
Hurry up, I want to discuss further point. Yes. Quickly. Okay, they are done. Yes, are done. What about others? What about others? Done or not? Okay. Esha, what is the first one answer? Esha, what is the first one answer? Answer me in chat box, don't worry about it. Hurry up. बेटा ये मुझे पसंद नहीं है, आप लोग मुझे इग्नोर कर रहे हो. आई लीव द लेक्चर. यू आर इग्नोरिंग मी. आई डोंट लाइक दिस थिंग. Seriously, I don't like this thing that you are ignoring to your teacher. Rakesh said, there are so many trees in the forest. No, the question is, Rakesh said that there were so many trees in the forest. The right answer is, there were so many trees in the forest. Rakesh said that there were so many trees in the forest. Kavya, what is the second one? Kavya, what is the second one? Kavya, what is the second one?
The Bersoon said their parents didn't want this girl to leave their home.
So answer is what? What is the answer? The Bersoon said their parents did not want to these girls to leave their homes. What is the answer?
Debe asked their parents.
It is an interrogative sentence. Is it an interrogative sentence, beta? Is it an interrogative sentence? वो इंट्रोगेटिव सेंटेंस है काव्या. काव्या
नो सर.
नाउ आई विल लीव द क्लासरूम. आई लीव द क्लासरूम. आई डोंट वांट टू टेक अ लेक्चर. यू कांट रिप्लाई मी नाउ. नन ऑफ यू रिप्लाई मी.
Sir, I don't know the second answer.
I am telling, is it an interrogative sentence or affirmative sentence? You know or not? ये प्रश्नार्थ वाक्य की विधान वाक्य है. काव्या.
Yes, sir.
Is it an interrogative sentence or affirmative sentence?
Sir, affirmative sentence.
Huh. So affirmative sentence is there. So which are the helping verbs we have to use? Last year I taught this thing. And it is not too much old. Only 2 months is away. The last topic is direct indirect speech is there. Am I right or wrong? See, when there is the interrogative sentence is there, then and then only of ask, inquire, inquired word you have to use. Now I am telling about just give the brief introduction of direct indirect speech. Okay? Not I am telling about directly I am taking you into interrogative formation. Here the speech is, first of all, you know about direct indirect speech regarding affirmative formation. Which type of the changes we have to do in affirmative sentence and same changes you have to do in interrogative sentences also. But there is a change is there that we are using that. The here in interrogative sentence we are not using that. Tabazum said that their parents did not, had not want. Did not is wrong, had not. Beta, have your table? Have your table that last year I gave you? Last year I gave you
yes,
the table.
Yes, sir,
name.
I have.
Right? In table note you have to see that if there is a have or has or did is there used, which type of helping verb we have to use in the sentence? बेटा डायरेक्ट इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच रिमेंबर इफ यू नो द टेंसेस देन एंड देन आफ्टर यू कैन चेंज द सेंटेंस डायरेक्ट टू इनडायरेक्ट स्पीच. नाउ हियर दिस फाइव सेंटेंसेस दैट इज इन योर होमवर्क राइट. दिस फाइव सेंटेंसेस दैट इज इन योर होमवर्क यू हैव टू सॉल्व इट. आई वॉन्ट टूडेज इवनिंग लेक्चर. सेकेंड थिंग now direct indirect speech means what that we are directly conversation with each other that is a direct speech when you are reporting my words to your parents or any other person that time I was absent and that is known as indirect speech. Now last year I taught you the sentences regarding affirmative sentences but this time you have to learn about interrogative sentences that how interrogative sentences which is in direct speech you have to change in indirect speech. Which types of the changes you have to do, the thing you have to learn here. Right? See, same thing is there, reporting speech and reported verb is there. Now we know there are two types of interrogative sentences. Am I right or wrong? There are two types of interrogative sentences. Right or wrong? Right or wrong? Right or wrong?
Has he done a cut?
One is yes no question answer and second one is WH question answer. Right? One is beta right W R I T right not R I G H T right. Sahi hai ya galat hai? Main aisa puch raha hu. One is and second one is yes no question answer right. One is WH question answer and second one is yes no question answer. Then how the WH question answer we have to change into affirmative indirect speech and how WH question we have to change into this kind of sentences, that thing I will teach you when I will at Morbi, right? Okay, so don't worry about it, but remember you should keep it the tables with you. You should keep the tables with you. So it is easy for you that how the sentences change, that is direct into indirect speech when there is an interrogative sentence in the direct speech. That is known as reported speech. That is known as reported speech. You can see in your textbook. You can see in your textbook. Page number 4. Page number 4. You can see that. Have you opened it? Have you opened it?
Yes, sir.
So, what is the observation? First one, Rome said, what are you going to do? What is the answer? See that. What she was going to do. Rome said, what are you going to do? So what she was going to do. Right? See this here. Now change is that. First sentence, when there is a comma, inverted comma sentence, that is an interrogative sentence. Do you see that? There is a question mark is there. Have you observed it? Have you observed it?
Yes.
Have you observed it? And second one is what? B, you can say Rome asked what she was going to do. Now it is an affirmative sentence. Now it changed into affirmative formation. See that. It means when there is an interrogative sentence in the direct speech, but when we change into indirect speech, the sentence will turn into which form? Affirmative formation. Okay, affirmative formation. Another thing that here we are in affirmative sentence, we are using that instead of comma into inverted comma when we change into direct indirect speech. But here remember there are two things. If the sentence in yes no question, it means is, am, are, was, were, have, has, had, did, could, would, should, usse puche gaye ho, right? It means with the modal auxiliaries and with the helping verbs. The question is asked. That time we have to use what, if, and whether. That time we have to use if and with. Got it? Got it?
Yes, sir.
Instead of, you have to use if and with. Another thing that according to the tenses, we have to change. If it is in simple present, so we have to change into simple past. If it is in simple past, so we have to change into past perfect. If it is in present continuous, so we have to change into past continuous. If it is in past continuous, so we have to change into past perfect continuous. This thing, you know, that whatever the tables that I gave you, you have to keep it with you when I will teach this topic. You have to keep it with you when I will teach this topic. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Now, apart from any other doubt, you can ask me. Then after I will go forward. Because today I will not teach direct indirect speech without board. I have no board here. And that's why today evening I will give you the introduction of the new chapter. Hello.
Yes, sir, no doubt.
No doubt.
No, sir.
Any other? Divyanshu? Divyanshu?
Yes, sir.
Is there any doubt, beta?
No, sir.
Is there?
No.
No. Okay. Now another thing, that when there is a WH questionnaire is there, when there is a WH questionnaire is there, so remember, WH question itself, it turn into the reported verb. WH question itself, it is a turn the reported verb. Now you can see in the example, see that, what are you going to do? Right, so same question is there, Rome asked what she was going to do. Same question is there, that what Rome, what she was going to do. And second question, she asked Soham, where did mother go? So same way, where mother had gone. See that, where is there? But we have to change the subject and helping verb. Here is that, where did mother go? But here in second sentence, you can see that, where mother had gone. Have you seen this thing? Did you see this thing?
Yes, sir.
Did you see this thing? Right?
Yes, sir.
So see this thing. This is the changes is there. This change is there. So remember this thing. Keep it this in your mind. You have to do a lots of practice. If you have a grammar book at your home, you have to do this exercise. You have to do this exercise. I will give you lots of exercise, but before we have to complete our syllabus. Clear? Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, remember this thing. Next lecture I will discuss. It means not today, when I reach at Morbi. Might be tomorrow I will reach at Morbi. Right, that time I will use with the examples. I will teach you with the examples. What are the changes you have to do? What type of the changes we have to work here? There's lots of things that you have to learn. Is that clear? Is that clear?
Yes,
is that
sir.
Clear? Okay. So, bye-bye everyone. Take care. Sorry, today's homework is that you have to solve unseen passage number 1. Did you complete your seen passage number 4? Did you complete seen passage number 4?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? Did I
Yes,
give you
sir.
homework? Yes. So solve unseen passage number 1 in your worksheet. That is your today's homework. Okay? Solve unseen passage number 1. That is your today's homework. Got it, everyone? Got it?
Okay, sir.
Bye-bye, everyone. Take care.
Bye, sir.